We'll return to the West Coast for our look back, though, in political history in 2001. Our Conservation Minister and Alliance MP Sandra Lee upset many coasters by refusing permission for an extension to a gold mine on conservation land near Reefton. Labor MP Damien O'Connor, and remember they were part of the same government at the time, got in a bit of trouble when he called her gutless and refused to apologise.
Allowing the open cast mine proposed for Reefton would have created a huge lake of toxic tailings, like the one left at Gold Cross Mine in Coromandel. Conservation Minister Sandra Lee turned the miners down, worried the tailings would spoil the neighbouring park. But that decision creates another toxic problem for the coalition.
That was as polite as I could be, given my feelings when I heard the decision.
He's also accusing a senior advisor in her office of bias. Conservation advisor Kevin Smith left the top job at Forest and Bird to work at the Beehive. Sandra Lee has so far declined to comment to One News on the Labor backbencher's attack. Her silence is leaving the Prime Minister, Helen Clark, to do the talking.
It's not for me to back or oppose it. It's a statutory decision that she has made. The Cabinet's taken no part in it. We have not seen the documents.
Does Mr O'Connor owe Ms Lee an apology?
Well, Damien O'Connor's always had a lot of leeway from the Labor Party to advocate for the West Coast. Damien is known for forthright advocacy on behalf of his electorate. I've in the past been called ignorant by Damien myself.
It's that latitude which allowed Damien O'Connor to win the seat a third time last election.
Damien O'Connor there. The West Coast, what a great place. Right, let's bring back the panel with some hits and misses before we go Heather. You can go first.
Well, lots happened internationally this week, but my hits and misses are domestic ones in New Zealand. So my hit is Andrew Little, who this week announced Chester Burrows would lead his criminal reform, criminal justice reform advisory group, and I think that's a great call. Chester's well qualified for that across a range of areas, but I think it also shows Andrew Little has really found his niche. He's settled really well, particularly into the justice portfolio, where he's prepared to take a big picture view and set politics aside to actually make sure that we're going to make some progress in this problematic area.
Very good. Yeah. Oh, no, we need to miss.
My miss is Golriz Garaman, who actually is at completely the other end of the spectrum, I think, from Andrew Little in terms of how she's conducted herself. For the second time in about 3 months this week, she announced that she was New Zealand's first ever female defence spokesman. Annette King was Associate Minister of Defence. I was the spokesperson for defence for the ACT Party from 2005 to 2008 and an Associate Member Minister for Defence. But she's sort of backing herself on Twitter and has created a social media storm. MPs have an amazing platform, a very privileged platform to do good things. And my advice would be to just stop talking about yourself and get on and help those people that really need it.
Well, my hit and miss are both in relation to the nurses' dispute this week. I think, you know, from a hit point of view, the nurses' organisation and the DHBs are to be congratulated, really, on how the first day of national strike action for nurses in 30 years was managed by them collectively, and how it enabled nurses to express their voices without compromising life-preserving services. So that's a real hit. In terms of the misses, I think the government's got to get off this position of there being no more money available to solve this problem. There is clearly money available to make a shift in their position. They are saying that long-term they want to do more. If it's a matter of shifting some of that long-term closer to today, I would imagine that it would be a fairly simple matter now to bargain an outcome to the dispute without causing, you know, further aggravation among nurses themselves over how they sort of end this dispute.
Thank you. Jennifer, we'll have to be quick.
Yeah, 60 Kiwi CEO leaders coming out in support of the Climate Change Commission and in line with Productivity Commission report. So really going to make, you know, take a leadership role in that space. So that would be my hit. My miss is Gareth Morgan calling us all fat, complacent, and
it's a good way,
you know,
to get
whatever.
Elected,
you know, really, he's not giving voters much credit in their decision to not choose him.